Thank you, Kamakshi, and thank you, Julie. These women represent what we'll hear about tonight. They are true women of vision. With their technical excellence, with their very important leadership capabilities, they had the vision and courage to make a difference. It's women like them and all of you that will change the face of technology. Every day, women are creating, innovating, and leading the way to a world increasingly connected. Connected with technology. That's what we're about. The partner companies that we work with are one way that people are connected. And as partners, they work year-round to develop new programs, understand the latest research and insights, understanding how to increase the women in their organizations. It is these companies that are making a commitment that will change our world. And so our work would not be possible without the support of these partners. I'd like to recognize not only the companies, but the executives, the HR professionals, the diversity executives, and the so many women that work at these partner companies. Together, we are creating an inclusive culture that opens the doors to women's unique and highly valuable talent. So let's give them a round of applause. I would also like to thank the Anita Borg Institute Board of Trustees, who's on the screen. This group is an extraordinary group of individuals that have made a commitment to the work of the Anita Borg Institute. And they are opening a wide range of perspectives as we think about the future. They understand the value of diverse teams and the need to include the best and the brightest. So let's give them a round of applause. If you've been around us very long, then you've almost always met some of the staff at the Anita Borg Institute. This is a committed group of individuals that day in and day out spend their time making a difference in our world. And not only should we give them a round of applause, but next time you see them, go up and say thank you. And thank you. At the Anita Borg Institute, our mission is to connect, inspire, and guide women in computing and work with organizations that see innovation as a strategic imperative. We continue to build on the programs and initiatives that Anita Borg, who is a very close friend of mine, started over 20 years ago. Programs like the well-beloved Grace Hopper Celebration and the Sisters Network. This year, we're so excited because we're going to launch the Dot Local on local communities. This year, we will launch in Silicon Valley, Washington, D.C., Boston, Los Angeles, and New Delhi. The ABI.locals was piloted in New York, and we have been very excited about the success that we saw as we held our first GHC1 in New York earlier this year. This provides students with the opportunity for connection and inspiration with their local communities, as well as all the women and organizations that live in that local area. We know from experience that connections and community increase women's sense of belonging and reduce isolation and support women as they grow their technical careers. If you want to know more about all of our programs, please visit our website at indeedofwork.org. We want you to be involved. And now, it's my pleasure to introduce Fran Berman. Fran Berman is the, I always have to get this right, Edward P. Hamilton Distinguished Professor of Computer Science at Rensselaer Polytech Institute. She's also the chair of the U.S. Data Research Center. She's the chair of the board of the Niederborg Institute. And Fran is also a very close friend. Please welcome to the stage, Fran.
Well, I can barely see you all, but I can't tell you how amazing this is. There's a lot of brain power in this room. Thank you, Telly. All of us spend a lot of time at our jobs, and finding the right job in technology is a complex decision for any engineer, programmer, and professional. You bring your best to making your company successful, and you want your company to bring its best to making you successful and helping you develop professionally. The focus of companies on inclusivity and diversity is important to us all. And culture and individual achievement is the yin and the yang that can recognize and develop skills. Women of vision like you make the most of their abilities when they work in companies of vision. ABIE is making it easier for women to discover which companies are working to create cultures that support and empower women, as well as helping companies develop cultures that encourage diversity and inclusion. This year, 35 companies participated in ABIE's Top Companies for Women Technologists initiative. Collectively, these companies have a U.S. technical workforce of over 435,000 employees, and are providing key leadership for positive cultural transformation in our industry. Tonight, we recognize one company in particular who has made substantial progress recruiting, retaining, and advancing women in technical roles. But first, we're going to do something a little bit different. We want to recognize 12 other industry leaders with the highest overall scores on participation of women at all levels and year-over-year growth across multiple measures. All of these companies are succeeding at increasing the participation of women. And they're there on your screen. And are included on ABIE's Leadership Index. So this is really special for this year. Let's give them all a round of applause. Thanks for your leadership, for all you've done in the past, and I know all you plan to continue to do in the future. And now we want to share with you the winner of the 2015 ABIE Top Companies for Women Technologists Initiative, BNY Mellon. We're really excited that they're here. Here to accept the award on behalf of BNY Mellon, please welcome Lucille Mayer, Chief Information Officer of Client Experience Delivery.
Thank you. Thank you, Tilly. Thank you, Fran. And many thanks to the Anita Borg Institute. On behalf of BNY Mellon and all of my colleagues in technology, I'm honored to accept the Anita Borg Top Company Women in Technologists Award. I'm so proud of all that BNY Mellon has done to advance women within our company and within technology in particular. But I'm even more proud that we have gone a step beyond and joined forces with incredible organizations like the Anita Borg Institute and many other forward-thinking companies, many of which are represented in this room today, to improve the entire technology industry for women. BNY Mellon has been a strong supporter of diversity in the workplace. Our Global Women's Initiative Network, or WIN, was launched more than a decade ago and has set a financial services industry standard with more than 5,000 active members worldwide across 56 different chapters. In 2013, we launched Women in Technology to engage with women and men who are invested in gender equality in technology across our 13,000 technology professionals. We want to actively support the now 30% of people that are women in our technology workforce and to increase that percentage. Our approach has been innovative, but that's not surprising. In our 230-year history, BNY Mellon has been particularly committed to innovation, particularly in technology. In the 1980s, we pioneered online trading, leveraging a platform called Prodigy, well before the internet was a standard, which led to further advances in online brokerage as the internet grew. We were the first to offer a mobile securities platform in the early 2000s. And as recently as last year, we were the first, and we are still the only financial services firm to be an active member of the Cloud Foundry. And as well, we've launched 4 technology innovation centers, including one in Palo Alto. And we're about to launch our 5th in London later this year. We know that diversity is key to innovation and that having more women as technologists is key to driving that innovation. And we have committed fully to making BNY Mellon a great place to work for all technologists, providing technology challenging and leading edge solutions, different ways that we're developing those solutions, and giving people career paths and mobility for the longer term. We recently created a global technology job family structure, which helps to articulate job roles, job responsibilities, job expectations, and advancement criteria. This helps us to get greater job satisfaction overall, but it also helps us to create an even playing field for all technologists because of a metrics-based culture. And we've combined that with a rigorous promotion process to make sure that everyone is considered equally. After launching Women in Technology, we decided we wanted to do things like create lean-in circles. We set a goal we'd have 2 or 3. By the end of 2014, we had 16. We had people coming out of the woodwork wanting to start their own lean-in circles. And we changed to meet our plans and to support that demand. We held several major internal and external developing programs and networking programs, which were largely attended by both men and women each year. And we also launched a robust sponsorship program, which involves all of my peers on the Technology Executive Committee, in which each one of them is working to sponsor a high-performing woman across our organization. We have a commitment to industry benchmarking, and as such, we have already begun to measure more than 130 services as part of our efforts to continuously improve. Participating in the Top Company Award gives us another opportunity to benchmark our capabilities against many leading firms in this important measure of our diversity growth. BNY Mellon's commitment to this critical issue is driven by the core team in our women, what we call in our Women Technology Group. I wish they could all be up here with me because they all work together as leaders and evangelists across our organization to drive change. This core team has also been very active in our company and is the driver as we reach out to the industry, where we, along with five other leading edge companies, partner together to formulate the ABIE.New York this year, and also participated in driving our inaugural One Day Grace Hopper that we held in March at Time Incorporated. And we're very thankful to the Anita Borg Institute for empowering each of us to make the technology field more open, more engaging, and more supportive of women. Our journey at BNY Mellon did not have to start with a blank sheet of paper. But Anita Borg helped us by giving us a network for us to share best practices. And we took a lot of our learnings and we took them back to our organization and we executed upon them the way that was right for our firm. However, it's going to take all of us, a community of companies and organizations, to improve the technology field for women. The efforts of everyone in this room tonight are driving the change that is needed in the tech industry to power the voices and the contributions of women. Like open source, the power is in the community and in the shared improvement. ABIE brings us together, but it's up to each of us to take responsibility for making the results better, for sharing our best practices together, and for making the opportunities in our firm where women can thrive and grow. This has been a hugely important journey for me and all of our women in technology, and lastly, for our male allies as well, many of which are my partners on the executive committee. And of course, our most important male ally, our corporate CIO, Suresh Kumar, who through his visionary leadership is driving tons of change at BNY Mellon. Our women technology organization is just one aspect of that change. What's even more important that I know that the advances we are making in improving the technology careers for women are going to reap great benefits for our clients who are always front and center of everything we do at BNY Mellon. So on behalf of my company and my colleagues, I thank you all for naming BNY Mellon as the top company for women technologists and look forward to continuing to be a change agent to drive our industry to a place where everyone can maximize their potential and make a difference in whatever that they do. Thank you and have a good evening.